attachment and really connect your heart to Allah is not easy. Is not easy at all. Is not easy at all. This is a journey by itself. Now, what happened now about this journey? How it started? It started with Angel Jibreel alayhi salam came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and according to some of the report, not all, he was near the Kaaba. He was near, very near the Kaaba, called Hijr. Hijr meaning just like 1 feet or 2 feet. And what happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he heard something, he told him, come on, ya Muhammad. Come on. And he looked, he find Angel Jibreel alayhi salam. And with Angel Jibreel, he took him with an animal with him. This animal, according to the report, is between a mule and a donkey in size, with two wings in the side. Very white, very shiny white. And one of the description about it is, it put its own feet where it has its own eyes. Think about it now. It put its own feet, the front feet, where has her own eyes. No. Think about it. Meaning, if his eyes, for example, looking at this mountain, the moment his eyes reaching the mountain, his foot will be there.
That's what I mean.
How fast it will be? Huh? Yeah. And even then, Jibreel alayhi salam tell it to slow down for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he saw many caravan of his own tribe was in a desert, in a journey. This journey at this time, it used to take approximately 40 days straight in a desert by horse and camel. And some of the detail is, before he tried to ride in it, after Jibreel alayhi salam tell him to ride, the animal gets shaked. He said, what are you doing? Do you know who he is? This Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Nobody ever will be in the top of you better than him. Calm down. And they went to Jerusalem. This trip called Isra. Why? Because he walking fast at night. When they went, he let him in a certain door, they call door al-anbiya, the door of messenger. All the messenger have been standing there. And he asked him to choose between water or milk or wine. And Rasulullah sallam, he chose milk. He said, Jibreel alayhi sallam, he replied, he said, if you choose wine, your ummah will be finished. But you choose milk for your ummah, your ummah will be always in the right path, inshallah. We talk about yaqeen. 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 Yaqeen is not cheap. Yaqeen is not cheap. Imagine even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine, do you think the iman of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before the trip will be the same after the trip?
No.
No way. But look what Allah did. Wife, no wife. Money, no money. Uncle, no uncle. Support, no support. Finish. Everything is cut. Why? Allah tell you, come to me. Come to me. Is me, is not sufficient for you enough? This is the yaqeen. When whatever happened, it will not shaking you. And just drop it to Allah. This is iman. This is Iman. Because you know whatever what happening cannot be done without the will of Allah. And you cannot fix it until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you tawfiq. If I know that, what I will do? What I will do? I go to Allah. Any problem you have, go to Allah, you will find what you like. Any way you try to solve a problem or any situation in your life, the way you think, you will be drowning more. Don't ever forget that. The whole thing is a journey of Iman. Journey of Iman is not cheap. It's not cheap. And before you know it, if you really succeed, sometime Allah wipe you off before you reach. Yes. For wisdom, Allah know. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's ghayur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's really like jealous. The jealousy of Allah is different than our jealousy. Imagine He created us. He is a controller of everything. And He look at you. And He want you. And He love you. And He find you rely in somebody else. Imagine. Or you have faith in somebody else than Allah. Or you calling somebody else than Him. Do you think Allah will be happy with you? Or you get upset about something, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can fix it for you. When I was young, one sheikh, he said something, and it hurt me at this time. He said, we have no manner with Allah. He said, if we acting like that to somebody, this somebody will never love us. And he will hate us. Imagine if I tell you, Brother Shaukat, I am the king so and so. I have the keys of America. I have this, I have that. And you know for a fact, I really implementing what I say. And I'm so generous king. And after I tell you, Brother Shaukat, I take care about you. Don't worry, go home. And in a way going home, I send somebody with you. And I find the message coming. And he said, Brother Shaukat is worried. He's so worried about this and that. What I feel as a king. Is Brother Shaukat respect me? Is Brother Shaukat respect what I promise him? Is Brother Shaukat respect who am I? Is Brother Shaukat respect my status? What will happen to him? He will be in big trouble. Because he did not respect who am I. Imagine what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look at us. Wow. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do not give us mercy now, we will be in trouble. We have no politeness with Allah, young and old. We worry about every stupid detail in our life. And we do not worry about the feeling of Allah. How Allah look at us. We worry about a lot of stupid things. And what Allah worry about, astaghfirullah, care about, we do not worry about it. This is the difference between us and a companion. The companion was a championship to please Allah. Please. Do you know what the meaning pleasing? Meaning you did all duty and you tried to do the extra. You tell me to care about this room and vacuum it and make it nice. You find it is vacuum, is making nice, is organized, but you find flower and perfume and everything else. You don't tell me how you feel about it. You will be happy. I did my job and extra for you. Do we do that? This is why these people went to where they went. They walk in the water. They defeated big enemy. Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu in one of the battlefield with the Roman, Ma'arakat al-Yarmouk. Do you know how much in one day? How much he died in one day from the enemy? 250,000. 250,000 in one day. And you know how many our companion died in one day? Less than 35,000. Give me estimate. It will not make sense. And even according to the report, the majority of the 35,000 died actually in the preparation of the battle, more than the battle. Because from the fear of the Muslim,